This is a preview of the lecture video on the topic sonography of pain in the right lower quadrant. Short snippets of the various parts of the lecture video will follow. Having gone through the preview, if you wish to listen to the main lecture video, go to sonoshare.in. Patient presents with pain right lower quadrant. The goal of imaging and particularly ultrasound is to rule in acute appendicitis. Operation and its complications can be avoided, and a decision to operate remains a challenge till this day. Now, clinically, patient presents with patient with acute CT and MR, and the safety due to the radiation involved in CT and the ultrasound and a little more specificity than ultrasound. It is agreed, but if you see, it is about 10% more of the appendix, then you have to suggest clinical reassessment and complementary MRI and CT, but it can vary from 5 to 25 centimeters in length, and the width is 6 millimeters. The base of the appendix is about 2 centimeter technique to be followed in pain right lower quadrant. It is in a transabdominal scan. You have to use the high frequency probe. Scan the right iliac fossa. Then technique is use the high frequency probe, the linear probe, use 5 to 12 megahertz, and you have to follow the graded compression technique. The graded compression in many patients, you will pick up the cross section of the either the normal or the abnormal appendix, and then you can rotate to see the appendix is below the cecum. You will see the cross section of the appendix. So this is abnormal appendix, that is the cross section. Once you have seen this, then you rotate the transducer for the any of the bowel, because appendix is also a part of a bowel. You will see the gut signature in the wall, and when you turn for the long axis, you will see the so fail to pick up any other abnormality, but tenderness is present in the right iliac fossa. Then you do suggest a CT scan. The AP thickness of the appendix will be more than 6 millimeter, it will be non-compressible. Even when you compress, it will continue to most 100% of acute appendicitis. Now, role of color Doppler. So when you do color Doppler, you may see acute. Here it is filled with pus. The wall thickening is not well seen, but it is filled with pus. How to say that it is pus? When all features are there, and the gut signature, the AP thickness is 8 millimeters. Discontinuity in the wall of the appendix here and here. Now here there is some fluid accumulation anterior to the appendix in cross section. So that is abscess. Now this is a patient presenting with pain right abdominal ileum and the appendix here in cross section with inflamed fat, and there may be some fluid. So you see the thick walled appendix again filled with pus. There is a fecaloid in the neck. So that is peritonitis, bowel loop in the right iliac fossa. And related to that, you see the thick wall appendix in cross section. And then when you do the rotation to the ileum and in cross section. So this is retroileal, and this is cecum, and this is a paracecal appendicitis with a much thickened appendix in long axis and the short axis. That is aorta, IVC. Appendix is almost yes. You see movement in this lumen. So this is due to the worm movement, loss of weight. You see slightly thick walled cecum, but a markedly thickened appendix, retrocecal look. And in cough, there will be bulge during cough. There may be an abscess in the right iliac fossa after appendicectomy. Now, stump inflammation is pain in the right iliac fossa. Now, this is a patient who had appendicectomy. He presented with non-healing sinus. In the, there is a long axis and the short axis. What is seen classically is the layering. You see the layering. This is the called the cut onion mucosal. So that indicates that it is a leaked, that is the long axis and the short axis. You see the layer. You see here, there is scalloping. And this scalloping is due to the mass of mucinous cystadenoma presentation, but you see the stratified thickening of the cecum, ileum with a diverticulitis. Even though it is rare, but it is definitely a differential diagnosis. The Meckel's diverticulitis has a varied appearance. You see stratified thickening of the tip of the cecum alone in long axis and in short axis, and it will be tender. But appendix will be normal, common on the distal part. Very rarely you can get a cecal diverticulum, which has to be differentiated from acute appendicitis. Mental infarction is another important differential diagnosis, where you see a tender mass of inflamed fatty structure, that is the omentigitis of ascending colon, which is again more common on the left side, but rarely it may be seen. On color Doppler, there will be normal flow in the right renal vein, differentiating from thrombus, and on color there is no flow. So that is iliac vein thrombosis. Again, patient with ascites, and then you see in the retroperitoneum in the right upper quadrant, there is inflammation with little fluid around, showing that it is an incarcerated hernia. It can be a hematoma, where the rectus sheath hematoma be visible outside. So this occurs through the weakness of the junction of linea semilunaris and semicircularis. Here, this is the rectus and fossa. Now, rarely, particularly in children, the pain to the right iliac fossa may be referred because of pneumonia. So most asked about the question, mesenteric lymph nodes. Now, mesenteric lymph nodes, when we started using the high frequency scan, the various useful causes of pain right iliac fossa, but other causes in the women in a male. So that concludes examination of the right iliac fossa to either rule in acute appendicitis or rule out a diagnosis most of the times. But the word of caution is you have to follow a meticulous technique to pick up the conditions causing pain.